And hello, fellow gamers. I am back yet again playing another video game. Imagine that. This is Gremlins 2, the new batch on the NES. I'm, as usual, playing on a real NES with a real copy of the game and a real NES controller. This is one of many games made by Sunsoft for the NES, and like a lot of their NES efforts, it has fantastic music and has the trademark Sunsoft bass, as it's called, which is, you know, awesome. And as typical for Sunsoft games, very good graphics and animation. And as I was explaining before the recording in the pre-show on the live stream, very good production values overall for this game. And I get hit by instantly by the first easiest enemy. That's good. So I'm playing as Gizmo here. I have played a little bit of this game before, but I'm far from an expert at it, which is why this is a Jeremy Tries, not a Jeremy Plays. But beyond the fact that I'm playing as Gizmo, and I appear to be traversing the building from Gremlins 2, I don't know hardly anything about this game, other than a previous personal play experience, and actually kind of enjoying it, which is surprising for a licensed game. But on the NES, Sunsoft did not make shit. By which I mean, they didn't make shitty games. Unless you really want to count Fester's Quest. But I think Fester's Quest was a victim of the license, in that case. So I think... Okay, pogo stick. Oh, that's like invincibility. Sort of. Or no? That just makes it like really super easy to kill everything in one hit. Okay. But Fester's Quest, I think, was a game that started out as a completely different game, and then they kind of shoehorned Uncle Fester into being the hero, which I don't think helped. Anyway, so I guess that was the goal. I guess I went up a floor in the elevator, and now it says 16 there. I don't know if that's the actual floor number I'm on now, or if it always says 16. Perhaps Matt Myers in the chat, who says that he has this game, could answer that question for me. And by all means, if you have any tips to offer me, feel free to let fly with them. I'm getting the feeling that there's multiple branching paths in this game, because there is a path in the first level that I didn't take. Oh wow, a magnifying glass. Apparently damages everything on the screen. I'm not exactly sure what all these spheres are that I'm picking up either. Like, let's hit start. There is an inventory screen here. I'm picking up crystals apparently, and I have 480 of them. Of course, one heart, and you start with absolutely no lives, but one balloon. I remember from my playtesting that the balloons are sort of lives, in that if you fall in a hole or something, then Gizmo will reappear hanging from a balloon, and then you have a few seconds to position him on the screen where you want him before he drops. In there? No. And spider. Haha, I can shoot him through the wall. Gizmo is ripped as fuck. Wonder if I can use these crystals to buy things at a shop or something eventually. Like maybe this. What item would you like? Okay. Let's see. I say yes. Okay, now I get to pick an item. So I have no lives whatsoever. Let's go for a life. Costs 150, yes. I only get to buy one item. I could have bought more than that. That sucks. I think at the end of this level, I will glance back at the chat and see what people have been saying. can't get in there. The way... Oh, shit. Yeah, I had one heart. I just used my one life. The control in this game is actually very, very good. Even the jumping, even in this perspective, controls pretty well. It's not overly sensitive, it's not sluggish. Gizmo moves at a good rate. What the fuck is that? Okay, I got a big-ass match. Dripping water. Oh, water is dripping on him? Or is dripping on a table above him, maybe? Oh, this is how these guys get created. Yeah. Because as we know, you're not supposed to get him. The Mogwai's wet. So they shove him into a air duct, I guess. Which, by the way, look at all this cutscene stuff for an NES game. That's awesome. Let's have a look at the chat here. Jay says, good production value seems unusual for a tie-in of that era, indeed. In fact, pretty much the the status quo for licensed tie-in video games since the beginning of time, all the way up until now, is that they're generally shit. Says the only other things I could think of that were good tie-ins are DuckTales and maybe the Ninja Turtles game, indeed. And Matt Myers says, Sunsoft did make some awesome games. Batman's one of my favorites. Indeed, that's another very solid game. Very hard game, too. And also, excellent music. Matt says, sorry, I missed your question about what you needed help with. I think it was... I don't even remember now. It was maybe what the purpose of the little spheres were that I was picking up, but I figured it out as crystals, and you use them to buy items in the shops. Sean says, no, don't get him wet. That's how they have babies. You see, when a Mogwai and a drop of water love each other very much... No, I'm kidding. What the... That? Whoa! Okay. Avoid those. Ow! See, I tried to jump over it and I couldn't. So I've learned that. I got a different weapon. Oh, it's that match that I picked up. It's like a fire rod or something. And I can bomb the bombs before they bomb. Ha. Okay. And I know those are obviously electrical lines. Now, can I jump over them? I know a way to find out. Yep. I'm guessing I can't kill those. And I can't go through those. Shit. I literally have no idea where to go, so I'm just kind of going. Oh, there's a shop. Let's see. So I get a choice between a jar of Pepto-Bismol, or a balloon, or a jar of piss. So, I'm feeling pissy. It only costs 50. Seems remarkably cheap. Sure, let's find out what it does. Oh, you get triple fire. Okay. I like the piss. Can't go anywhere else this way. Boing, boing, boing. Oh, shit. Oh, there goes my balloon. I am very close to game overing. I have no balloons, no lives, and one heart. spike ball block my shots. Oh, you fucking spider scared me back into the spike ball. There is a password system, and that is a nice short password as well. I probably start over, yes, from the beginning of the stage. And I lose the stuff that I did in the stage, but not what I did up to the stage, because I still have the fire rod. I know that this way is the shop. No, there's not a shop. It remembers that I used the shop, even though I game over it. Come on, game. Fuck. Oh, can I go over this thing? No. That'd be an interesting way to get secrets. Oh, the shop was over here. Okay. Whew. Wonder if I lost all my crystals. So that probably refills my life meter. Looks like maybe it did, but I don't know how many hearts I had when I went in there. Did you see that? There was a shadow dude over there and he ran off. He done. Are you in an OFT? Wonder if anybody gets that reference. You know, I think I would fit in great on Tumblr, since I basically only speak in references and memes. You crazy ass little spider. Yeah, it looks like I did lose my crystals. Oh, there's another poker stick. And I say, fuck you, to everything. Notice I used the poker stick to get the crystals that were on the spikes. No elevator at the end of that level. I did notice, though, I think, well, no, because I was thinking that the elevator previously took me straight from World 1 to World 2, but it didn't, because there was multiple World 1 levels. Crazy helicopter gremlin. Homing flaming breath. How do I do this? Bitch. Okay, I clearly cannot hit him from over here. And I can move diagonally, but as soon as I let off, he faces a direction, so can't shoot diagonally. At least not from standing on there. Oh, shit. Shit. Yep, that's a game over. Jay says this music is definitely kick-ass. Indeed, I liked this music enough, even though I'd hardly played the game, that I made sort of a soundtrack of the game, in that I recorded MP3s off of all some of the music in the game, not all of it, just the ones that I liked. And so, since almost all of my music is on my phone, and I listen to music on my phone while I'm at work, sometimes music from this game plays while I'm making pig software, which is a strange experience. Sean said, when I got the three-way weapon, he says three time he says 3x fire, still can't hit the damn rat. And Jay says, yes, he was listening to the song for that stage I was playing, and he says, this is so Grant Kirkhope. That's interesting. I hadn't made that connection before, but I wonder if there's any inspiration there. And Matt Myers confirms that the dude that I was trying to get past is apparently, quote, tough as hell. So it's not that I blow, it's that it is indeed hard. Wonder if I can, like, land in front of him, like, right on the ledge, right in front of him, and just friggin' wail on him. See, it worked. I only had to hit him twice. But I burned a balloon in the process. Okay, not going that way. Oh, good. I was like, what the fuck? There's a platform up here. Look at this dick. This level is absolutely full of gremlins. Thus living up to its name. They call the game Gremlins, and god damn it, it's got gremlins. Oh, shit. Oh, piss. That's game over. Man. Nice. Jay says that he just shared the YouTube link to this song with Grant Kirkhope, and Grant Kirkhope agreed that it was kind of his style. That's cool. Speaking of Grant Kirkhope, Ukulele comes out on the 11th. Since there's no longer going to be a Wii U version, I either have to get an Xbox One or a PS4, or get the PC version. Ass. I'm gonna shoot this guy in the butt. Fucker. He only took two hits before. What the hell? I wonder, would it be simpler to just jump on the spikes and jump across and just take the damage? Or will it even let me do that? Well, find out. Nope! It's effectively the same. See, now I'm just getting impatient and making stupid mistakes. Oh, that's true. Jay says that on the subject of ukulele, he says, I think you should do what I'm doing, get a USB N64 controller for the PC version. Which, just a couple days ago, Jay and I were talking about that, and he informed me that indeed the controls for ukulele, although it is a modern game, are no more complex than can be done with a Nintendo 64 controller. So you literally... If you don't get a USB compatible controller that looks like an N64 controller, then you can also get, or you can instead get a USB to N64 controller adapter and then plug in a real N64 controller into your PC. I also hear, fuck, just jump right on top of them. That's a good idea. But I also hear that, Ukulele is going to have an N64 graphics filtering mode that makes it look like, and you, it's something you can turn on and off. You don't have to play it that way, but it makes it look like an N64 game, which I think is pretty cool. And totally makes sense because the guys that worked on it are, of course, from Playtonic, and they are former members of Rare, and of course, Rare's heyday was in the N64 days. I'm gonna keep trying. The stream has not been long enough yet. You know what I could really use right here is a pogo stick. Yes! Sweet! I actually killed him and didn't burn something from my inventory. Shit. Spawn the crystal inside the wall. It's shit. Let's ride this balloon as far as I can go. Shit, there's another one. But, fuck! Ah! Overcompensation! Matt Meyer says, what genre of game is ukulele? It is a 3D platformer very much in the style of Banjo-Kazooie, if that's your kind of thing. Which for me, it is. And it's very colorful and very animated, and damn near everything has a pair of googly eyes on top of it. And even though the name of the game is ukulele, it's not actually spelled like the instrument. It's spelled as if the words are literally spelled as if they sound. So yuka and lele. And it's named after the two main characters in the game, just like Banjo-Kazooie is Banjo and Kazooie. The two characters are Yuka and Lele. Yes! But twice in a row, I've killed the same dude the same way, so I might have figured that out. Damn it! Dude on the skateboard loves dropping his shit balls everywhere. Doesn't he see the sign on the wall that says no shitballs? I swear these gremlins have no regard for authority. He's disobeying the non-existent sign. How dare he? Yeah, there Jay has spelled ukulele correctly. And Jay says he didn't even think of a USB to N64 controller adapter, and so apparently he just bought one. That may be the most authentic way to play the game. And Jay, indeed, I think he's saying that the name of the game is kind of silly, but it's appropriate for the kind of humor Banjo-Kazooie was about. Indeed, and that's something that I loved about Banjo-Kazooie. It's like the entire game was tongue-in-cheek. It, not for a moment did it take itself seriously, and yet, like as far as story goes, especially dialogue between the characters, and yet it was at its heart a very solid action platformer kind of game. So just because it looked like it was silly in presentation didn't mean that it was a bad game by any stretch of the imagination. Fucker. I need to figure out a way to get over here and kill that guy without taking a hit. So what I've been doing most of the time up until now is I've been trying to jump around him and I've been hitting these spikes. Oh! You nutsack on a skateboard. Ah, that's a good point, Jay. He says, my sentimentality got the better of me when I realized just now that I could play ukulele with the exact same controller I played Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie with. Yes. That's true. In fact, I'm going to have to get one of those adapters, too. That reminds me, Jay, I remember a while back you retweeting something from some guy that was remaking brand new N64 controller control sticks, except they were made out of steel instead of plastic, which I'm guessing makes them way, way, way more durable. Any word on that? Have they actually been made? Because I think at the time, that was a few months ago, at least, they were still sort of in development. Shit. Oh, you know what? I think I just noticed something about that skateboard guy. It looked like he was only throwing those balls above and below him. So that means the next time I get here, what I'm going to try is stand right here and shoot him from the side. Then maybe I can avoid getting hit. And the reason why I keep standing right here rather than down at the bottom is because the platform doesn't go all the way down to the bottom. So I have a greater chance of landing on the platform if I'm further up the screen. That dude right there just will not come over far enough. Come here. That fuck. Yep, that's it. Hey, Odd Man 845 has joined us. Odd Man 845 says, I feel like crap. Do you want to know why? Indeed, because I was wondering, there was like a giant void that would normally be filled by you liking all the stuff first. In fact, Sean was the first to the stream tonight. So, unfortunately, Odd Man 845, that means you've lost your position as fan number one. It's now Sean. Jay says, I had bought a new N64 controller in 2000 specifically for Banjo-Tooie 2, so that would feel awesome. Yes. And Jay says, the thing I was talking about is called Steel Stick 64, and that's a very simple link to it. It's twitter.com/steelsticks64. He says, I think he's still working on perfecting the designs and getting ready to start producing them. I'm number 200-something on the waiting list, and I haven't heard anything about it yet. Okay. So that means there is a waiting list. Which means Jay can keep us apprised of any developments. The replacement sticks for those controllers are kind of a big deal, because even though, you know, Nintendo controllers are pretty damn durable. I mean, this is an original controller right here, and it works just as well as day one. Analog sticks still wear out. Not easily, but you'd be hard-pressed to go into a used game shop and find an original first-party controller that, for any system, that doesn't have a little bit of wiggle, a little bit of play in its sticks. And that's bad news, because it means that that's a range of control that you don't get in the game. Fuck. Man, that was a bad run. But the sticks can eventually get so bad that they can move entirely around their entire range of motion, and the system doesn't even know that they're moving. So to produce a durable replacement stick for a controller is pretty damn cool. Oh, damn, so that's what's been going on with Odd Man 845. Odd Man 845 says he feels like crap because Nintendo's being stupid, because they put a copyright claim on his video for using the Mario/Zelda theme. Yeah, they must have picked that up out of the, wait, the Mario/Zelda theme? But you played Pokemon. That's weird. You know, if that's what they say they found in your video, and that is genuinely not anywhere in the video, you can dispute the claim. YouTube does give you that capability. In fact, I almost had to use that, I was going to use that for my Super Mario Land video, because it wasn't Nintendo that time, it was someone totally bizarre I'd never heard of, filed a claim on it, because they said that some song of theirs was in it, and I would have started the claim dispute process, but in the email that I got from YouTube that said that the claim had been filed, the link for starting the dispute process didn't work. I could click it all day long, it didn't do anything. So there's probably somewhere on YouTube itself where I'd have to go dispute the claim. Like, I'd have to go to YouTube and actually find it instead of relying on that notification email. Damn it! See? I was trying to get a good jump over those spikes, and instead I ran into them. Okay, here's a test. Can he actually hit me right here? I don't think he can. Excellent. those fucks. Just waiting to come down here and fuck my day. Fuck! And they don't have to fuck my day. I can fuck my day better than they can. Just like that. Wait, what? That should have been game over. Was that a bug? Because I noticed that when I fell that time, it didn't do that noise going down with it. So maybe because I was shooting when I fell off the edge, it didn't record the death? Oh, you fucker! Ah! Still hit me from over there. Oh, okay. Oddman845 says that he got the copyright claim on his second stream. I guess I didn't get a notification for that. He says he was playing Mario Crossover. Well, that's weird. Because Mario Crossover is a fan game. But if it uses the original music, then they could still claim it. Man845 says they were like, oh, it doesn't matter if you're not making money off it, we're mad, haha, screw you. I don't think it's quite like that. And Man845 says, well, the video's still public, so I don't care. Yeah, that's the thing about a copyright claim is I've gotten lots of copyright claims on my videos, particularly ones for games made by Nintendo, just like in your experience. But my videos have never been taken down. And I'm like, that's fine. Like, if you want to take all the money, which, just like Oddman845, I'm not making money either, then that doesn't make any difference to me. Just don't take the video down. And they're not taking the videos down. So I'm like, okay. Do your claims if it makes you happy. If maybe there's a pattern to how he fires. Shit! It's tough to land right in front of him. Oh, you bitches. I did the hard part, which is get across there. Shit! That was just bad timing. Oh, Oddman845 says, I didn't watch the stream, you said you were busy. Oh, so that's what you were asking me about. Because he was asking me what I recommended for bit rates for live streaming. And so I gave some advice there. But I guess I didn't make the connection that you were asking me that because you wanted to know because you were going to do a stream. Like, right then. You fuckers. Okay, this guy's just firing continuously. I don't think there's a pattern. Damn it! Ah. It's so hard to just lane in front of him. Bitch. One thing I wish is that these enemies would at least drop some health. Because, yeah, they're dropping lots of crystals, but crystals don't do you any good unless you can get to a shop. That was just bad landing. Damn it. I collected the crystal that was balancing on the nothing. And it was balancing so well on that nothing. Just waiting for the right timing. And that wasn't it. Piss. Matt says it's been fun, guys, but it's time for me to say goodbye. Thank you for tuning in, Matt. Hope to see you on a future stream. This game is kicking some serious Jeremy posterior. So random. Also, is he smoking a cigarette? I think he is. Like, look at his mouth whenever he's not breathing the fire. See, look at that. A cigarette smoking in an NES game. Hmm. That got past Nintendo. I guess that's their explanation for how he's breathing fire. Facing the wrong way when I landed. That noise? What was that? I didn't get anything. Maybe that was just a glitched sound effect. What the? I fell through the platform because I took damage while I was standing on it. Okay, that's weird. Upman845 says, Jeremy, I bought you off eBay for $5, but I'm not for sale on eBay. I mean, I'm for sale. I'm a money slut. There's no doubt about that, but I haven't been whoring myself on eBay. Come on, fucker. There for a second, I thought he was never gonna fire. You bitch monkey fuck dick ass. I like that I figured out that trick, to just stand over here. There's a shop! Holy shit! I'm buying a life. Crap, yeah. This is the furthest I've ever gotten. Another one of those dudes. You know, they need to do something about the floors in this place. Janitors need to get on those spikes. And yes, I'm intentionally walking into the walls here because it looks like it. There might be an opening there that I could go through, but starting to think this isn't that kind of game that uses perspective like that. Like, the perspective looks like it's sort of slanted, but the collision is still two-dimensional. Holy crap! I beat the level! Man. Oh, it's boss time, I know that music. And it's a big pulsating dick. And almost instant death. But do I start back at the boss? No. I start back here, son of a bitch fucker. Same mistake over and over, which just proves that I'm insane. Because you know the definition of insanity is repeating the same behavior over and over and expecting different results, and that's exactly what I'm doing. Shit, okay, that was just dumb. Of me. Bitch. Yes, just get there. I find myself wondering if maybe the triple shot would be better for that boss. I don't know how many lives I still have, though. I've got a balloon, and that's only going to save me if I fall in a hole. Oh, you bitch ticket. Ticket to bitch. Sean's... Sean says, oh yeah, Jeremy, this is going to be an awkward conversation about eBay. And then Oddman845 says, Jeremy, there's a game about you on eBay called Jeremy McGrath. Nope, that's someone else. That would be Jeremy McGrath Supercross, which I've never played and don't own. But it is a title of a game that I heard at some point in my past. So, of course, it's in my brain forever. Yes, finally. I still take damage from that dickhead. Flying dickhead. I'm just gonna say fuck you to that guy. Yeah, he can't get over here anyway. So there's no point in staying to fight him. I only risk him stomping on my face. Hey! Hey, fucker! I shouldn't have made fun of him. Get off of my face. Well, that's bullshit. Key right there is just to not stop. And that guy just barely cannot reach me. Okay. So, I'm gonna buy the compressed piss again. Because this time... still don't have lives. But I do have more health. We took that one out in one shot. Or not one shot, in two. I'm wondering if actually hitting them with the stick does more damage than hitting them with the blasts from the stick. God, fucks are everywhere. Seems like shit. Seems like part of the way to win it in this game is to know when to say fuck it and walk away. Instead of just killing everything. Nice. Okay, made it to the boss with the super flamey stick. fine. You gotta die sometime. Shit! Damn it! Ah! Should have gotten out of that corner. Well, I think that's the end of this. I made somewhat progress, but pretty much the game's kicking my butt. So, yeah. Still not a bad game, though. Just very, very hard. So, yeah. End of recording, and hope you enjoyed. And next time I'll be live streaming is going to be on Wednesday, today being a Monday. I typically live stream on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at about 9 to 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. And you can be notified of when I have live streaming either by following me on Twitter, which you can find a link to my Twitter profile on my YouTube channel page, or you can follow me on YouTube itself in whatever form you want to and just turn on the notification thing. So, until then, see ya.